channel, Anamika's Eduspace. Now, this is an educational channel where you can get all the topics related to science. And in this channel, I welcome those people with interest in great learning with science. In this video, we are going to discuss about the syllabus of class 11-12 biology, and we'll start with biological sciences of higher secondary. And in the upcoming video series, you will get a detailed video upon each and every unit and the chapters covering all the minute details in each and every topics included in our syllabus. So before discussing our syllabus, let's study from the beginning and create our base and foundation. So upon topic science, why should we study science? The first question that arises in our mind is, why we should study science, what is science, and what are the purpose or what are the things which makes us to study science? Now, the systematic knowledge of a substance is science. The knowledge may be used for the purpose of construction or for destruction. It depends upon the person who possesses this knowledge. Man invented science to make human life more comfortable and happier. Its development has been so quick in every sphere of life that it is not possible to say what more wonders will be achieved in the times to come. Now, science is in every field, like starting from agriculture, industry, locomotion, entertainment, medicine, surgery, education, and all these have completely changed by the inventions and discoveries of science. So these are all the purposes why should we learn science. Now, this video will be mainly based on biology, that is, we are going to teach you about class 11-12 biology. So what is biology we should know? Biology is a Greek word which means bios means life and logos means study. Now, it is a science that deals with the study of the living objects. Now, who coined this term biology, or what is the origin of the term biology, where it came from? So the term biology has been coined by a French naturalist whose name is Jean-Baptiste de Lamarck, and it was coined in 1801. Now, it was a knowledge about life or living organisms, and then it, in a broader sense, it is known as a science which deals with all aspects of studying living organisms like their origin, their occurrence, their natural form, their external form, their organization, their life history, their inheritance, their interaction with the environment, etc. So these are all the fields which we study in biology, and biology is one of the earliest branches of natural science. Now let's get started and let's move to the syllabus of class 11 and 12 biology. So guys, the class 11 theory syllabus basically contains 5 units. The first unit is of 7 marks and it is the least important unit. Now, it contains 3 main chapters, that is science of life, where we study what is life, the definition of life, what are the characteristics of life, or you may say what are the characteristics of being a living being, just from the basic level. Then we'll study about biodiversity. We'll have a concept of biodiversity. We'll have a concept of species. In the next chapter, we'll have the in the taxonomy, about taxonomy and systematics we will study. And in the last chapter, we will study about classification of living organisms. There we will study the 3 main domains of life and the 5 kingdom classification done by Whittaker, the main classification, what is classification and what is the need for classification. We will study in the 3rd chapter of the first unit. And also in the latter part, we'll study about the classification of plants into major groups, like their salient features and 2 examples of each category. Okay, at least 2 examples. The major groups will be of plants like algae, biophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperms and angiosperms. 5 salient features of each of them and with the example. And in the animal category, we will study from non-chordate level to up to the chordate level, up to the class level we will study here. Okay, next, in the 3rd unit, that is cell structure and function, we will study about what is cell, what is cell theory, why cell is called the basic unit of life, about cell and its various organelles, about prokaryotic cell, about eukaryotic cell, about animal cell, about plant cell. Next, we will study in this unit only about chemical constituents of living cells, which are enzymes, biomolecules, what are biomolecules like the structure and the function of protein, lipid, carbohydrate, nucleic acid, what are enzymes, what are the types of enzyme, properties of enzyme action, all these we will study in the cell structure and function in the 7th chapter. Now in the 8th chapter, we'll study clearly about cell division. What is cell division? What is cell cycle? About mitosis, meiosis, their significance, each and everything we will study in the cell structure and function unit, that is in the 3rd unit, okay? Now coming to the 4th unit. 4th unit consists of plant physiology, okay? This is a vast unit and it almost contains 5 main chapters. That is, here we will study about transport in plant, how the movement of water, movement of gases, movement of nutrients and the cell-to-cell transport in plant is formed, okay? So this is we will study in 1st chapter of plant physiology. Next, in the 2nd chapter, we'll study about mineral nutrition. What are the elements, what are the essential minerals needed by the plant and what are their deficiency symptoms, that if the minerals are not present, then what will happen to the plant body? Next, in the 3rd chapter of 4th unit, we'll study in details about photosynthesis, which is an autotrophic mode of nutrition, okay? And we will also study in detail where the photosynthesis occurs, how many pigments are involved in this. In details we will study as we are in class 11 now. And next, in this plant physiology only, we will study about plant respiration, in which we will study about exchange of gases, cellular respiration, about 4 main processes like glycolysis, CCA cycles, about electron transport system, and also about the main thing I would mention, that is oxidative phosphorylation. It is also very important. And we will also study about what is respiratory quotient. So these are all important. If you have the syllabus or if you are downloading the syllabus from the given link, then please do note down and mark what are the important points I'm telling you from this. Now coming to the last chapter of plant physiology. So the last chapter of plant physiology contains plant growth and development. So what is plant growth and development? How seed germination is occurring? What are the phases of plant growth? What is plant growth rate? And what are the conditions needed for plant growth? What is dedifferentiation? What is redifferentiation? What is differentiation? And what are the plant growth regulators? Like, there are many plant growth regulators, approximately 5 main plant growth regulators. They are auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, ethylene and abscisic acid. We'll only study about details, their function and what are the role they are playing in plant growth and development. We'll also study about seed dormancy, about photoperiodism and about vernalization in this chapter only, okay? So 4th unit of plant physiology is complete with 5 main chapters. I hope it is clear. Now coming to the 5th unit. 5th unit contains human physiology, which is again a very important chapter in this course structure, okay? It contains almost 6 to 7 chapters in it. First is digestion and absorption. We'll study in detail about what is digestion, what are the role of digestive enzyme and all. Next, we will study about breathing and respiration. What are respiratory organs, different types of respiratory organs present in humans, present in animals, and also the mechanism of breathing and its regulation in humans. We will study about exchange of gases, how it occurs in our body, transport of gases, regulation of the respiration in humans, how the respiratory, what is respiratory volume, and about the disorders related to the respiratory system. So this is very important, the last one, that is disorders. Very small and minute questions come from this part only. Next chapter in human physiology is body fluids and circulation. So body fluids and circulation deals with blood, its all structure, its composition, deals with lymph and its function, deals with human circulatory system. Actually, in short, if we say human heart, its blood vessels, cardiac cycle, cardiac output, ECG, double circulation, etc. And also about the disorders of the circulatory system. So this is about the body fluids. Now coming to the excretory system, it consists of all the modes of excretion. It also consists of the disorders which are happening in the artificial dialysis and artificial kidney. About this also we'll study, and also about the disorders like renal failure, renal calculi, nephritis. These all are the disorders. So we'll study about this in the excretory products and their elimination chapter. Okay. Now the next chapter is locomotion and movement. What are the different types of locomotion, or what are the types of locomotion by which a primitive or a smaller groups of organisms can have a movement? Okay, so these are the types of movement like ciliary, fascicular movement, muscular, skeletal muscle movement. These all we'll study in the locomotion and movement chapter. In this chapter, we will also study about the disorders of the muscular and the skeletal system. Now in the second last chapter, we'll study about the nervous system, about the central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, visceral nervous system, and also there are other parts like about the function of eye, about the function of ear. Now comes the last chapter in the fifth unit, that is in the human physiology, which is chemical coordination and regulation. In this, we'll study about different types of hormones and mainly about the human endocrine system. And the role of hormones as messengers and regulators. We'll also study about hypo and hyperactivity related disorders like dwarfism, then goiter, etc., diabetes, Addison's disease. This all we'll study in human physiology in last chapter, that is chemical coordination and regulation. I hope the whole syllabus is clear. Now please go through the PDF or the file which I have linked below, and please do mark down where each and every point I have told which is important while studying class 11 theory syllabus, and also do watch the next video. If anyone is interested in class 12 syllabus, then please do watch the next video.